Hey, strangers, how did you get here? That's Centaur territory. I'm Zuruk, master weaponsmith of this tribe. It's not the best time for guests right now. We're at war with the forest hunters. They acted cowardly, unworthily, and arrogantly by hiding in their town when we offered them a united front against the Black Horseman Darkness. He settled in the dark woods. What? You also fight the Black Horseman? Good. I'll try to help you, but bring me something first. I've heard the dwarves make the strongest shields, although I've never faced them in battle. I hope this is true. Bring me a real dwarf shield. Strong shield indeed. I'll help you with such a service. So, what are you looking for in the dark woods? You came to ask these forest hunters for a bow? Those cowards? You hope they'd make a weapon capable of killing the Death Horseman for you? Ha ha! The centaurs are skillful weapon makers, as good as the forest hunters. Bring me a boarskin and a twig from the red tree. This is the largest, oldest tree in our forest. It grows behind the Onsis Glade. Redwood is most elastic and strong.
Thank you.
I'll need some time to make a bow and arrows. So, you'd better find the other materials and prepare a bowstring and arrowheads by yourselves. Make the bowstring from some durable spider web and cast the arrowheads from dark metal. This is a special grade of metal, capable of inflicting damage even on supernatural forces. I heard that deposits of it can sometimes be found in wasteland dungeons. When you are ready, get up to our workshop and assemble the weapon.
Just look at...
Thank you.
This is it. My end is near. The wound from Death's Scythe is fatal. You must go on. Use the boat to cross to Death's Castle. I think you hit him with the arrow. And chances are we managed to defeat him. If he has the compass, take it and bring it to Marin. Oh, wish we had a cure. Ah. Oh, thank you so much. You saved me. I feel my strength returning. I feel much better now. Let's go, quickly.
That's incredible. You defeated Death. But the most difficult task lies ahead. Stop darkness. We know he's found the compass of the worlds and is headed toward the stronghold. But praise the gods, when I hid the compass, I enchanted it with a spell of burdening. The closer darkness gets to the portal of the universe, the heavier the compass becomes. This is why he's moving very slowly, and so we have some time to prepare. I know what to do, but there's no time for long explanations. I'll need you to do one thing. Find a large glass lens. You'll be on your own, as Falner will stay with me. His tinkering talents will be of great use now.
Take this key and head to my refuge. Unlock my workshop. There you'll find the lens.
One more thing. Set off to Mount Gore again and ask him for a spell capable of destroying the Black Horseman's heart. Mount Gore will ask you for a flower in return. Take one from my flower bed. Remove the flower's protective field with this spray. Once you have everything, meet me in the tower's central hall.
begin, mortal? I know why you have returned. Good. I shall help you one more time. Bring me a clean sheet of paper. Place it inside a magical shell, and the spell will be granted. Wait. I know Marin asked you to find a lens. It will be more useful if you fill it with blessed light. Set off to the Ontus Glade. Place the lens on the ritual table and see for yourself. Take this part. It will help you to weave the magic.
Failed to stop darkness. He's already gone up and is about to open the portal. We might still have a chance, though. Go to the top. There you'll find a device we created against darkness. Insert the lens into it, and when darkness activates the compass, read the spell. Then immediately jump into the portal. It will take you back home. If you stall, you'll die together with darkness.
Suzanne, it was an honor to meet you. Our ascendants will compose legends about you throughout the Lost Lands.
Do not worry about us. Thank you. Goodbye.